Hello students, hope you all are well. Let's have our science class. We already completed our syllabus for first term exam, so it's time for our revision classes. You all know the syllabuses for first term exam, but I'm telling you again what are the syllabuses for our first term exam of science. There is chapter 1, plant reproduction. Chapter 2, habitats of animals. Chapter 4, skeletal and nervous system. Chapter 8, air and water. Chapter 10, our universe. And chapter 12, pollution. So, totally there are 6 chapters. Chapter 1, Chapter 2, Chapter 4, Chapter 8, Chapter 10 and Chapter 12. So, let's revise the Chapter 1 first. It is Chapter 1, Plant Reproduction. In this chapter, we learned about reproduction in plants, growing plants from seeds, growing plants from stems, roots and leaves, and seed dispersal. You know, reproduction is defined as a process by which an organism, it may be a plant or an animal, produces new individuals. Actually, living things all produce young ones like themselves. This is called the reproduction. In most of the plants, they make new plants through their seeds. We can get new plants from their seeds, from the seeds of that particular plant. So, in this chapter, we also come to know about the ways of producing new plants from different parts of plant. Firstly, production in plants. You know, most of the plants have flowers. And these flowers develop into seeds. And these seeds can give rise to a new plant of the same type as the parent plant. Here you can see in this first picture, once the flowers bloom, their petals dry and fall off. All of you know that. And the flowers turn into small fruits. As the flowers become dry and fall off, petals are fall off, then the flowers turn into a small fruit. And here in this picture, in this second picture, these fruits, then fruits grow big in size. And they may have only one seed or may have many seeds inside them. You know, a mango have one seed only, and a papaya have many seeds inside. Papaya, guava have many seeds inside. And here in this picture, you can see that these seeds give rise to the new plants. They need particular heat or warmth, soil, water, sunlight, and then a seed give rise to a new plant. Okay? You know, seeds are important source of food. In our everyday food, we have many types of grains. We eat many types of grains or seeds. For example, you know, that rice, wheat, gram, kidney beans, peas, all are seeds. And different spices like which we use in our kitchen every day. Coriander, mustard, cumin, these are also seeds. And you can see that seeds are of different shapes and sizes. Some seeds like castor, datura, mango are big in size, while the seeds of mustard, cardamom, cumin, these are very small in size. Rice, wheat, peas, all are small in size. So we learned that shapes and sizes of seeds are different. Now, how plants grow from seeds? Actually, plants produce many seeds, but all the seeds can't grow into new plants. Why? Because seeds require favorable conditions to grow into new plants. Only those seeds which get the right conditions, they can grow into new plants. Now, what are the right conditions? These are, first condition is, seeds should be healthy. Distorted seeds can't grow into new plants. So, seeds should be healthy. Damaged seeds do not grow into new plants. Next condition is, second condition, seeds should get right type of soil and minerals from it. Right type of soil and minerals, this is very important to grow a seed into a plant. Next, third one is, seeds should get right amount of water, air, light and warmth. Particular amount of water, air, light and warmth. Over water is not favorable for growing a new plant. Exact amount of water is required, and air, light and warmth in particular amount is required for growing a new plant from a seed. Now, let us see the structure of a seed. A seed is covered by seed coat. You can see here structure of a seed. A seed is covered by a seed coat. It is seed coat. You can see here the outer part of the seed is called as seed coat. Seed coat protects the seed, and inside the seed coat, seeds have fleshy seed leaves. This is seed coat and this is seed leaves. These seed leaves are also called as cotyledons. And cotyledons store food for the baby plant. Cotyledon store food for the baby plant. The baby plant uses this food till it grows in its own roots and leaves. This food is required by the baby plant. For that time when the baby plant can grow its own roots and stem and then leaves, then only it can produce its own food. Till that time, a baby plant gets its food from cotyledon. After the food from the cotyledons is used, young plants continue making their own food through photosynthesis. When a baby plant grows enough to produce its own food, then through the process photosynthesis, you know, it can make its own food. Okay? There is, I'm telling you important thing, that some seeds have only one seed leaf that are called as monocotyledons, and seeds having two seed leaves are called as dicotyledons. One seed leaf is called as monocotyledons, and seeds which have two seed leaves called as dicotyledons. Now it is germination. What is germination? When a seed gets all the favorable conditions, it grows into a baby plant, which is called as seedling. A baby plant is called as baby plant, always known as seedling. This process of a seed turning into a seedling is called as germination. So, what is germination? Definition of germination is clear to you. The process of a seed turning into a seedling is called as germination. During germination, when seed receives adequate water, it swells, leading to the bursting of its seed coat. Then the seed coat bursts and give rise to the baby plant. And inside the seed, the developing embryo gets its food from cotyledons. The baby plant first develops its root, and then a tiny green shoot emerges from the other end. You can hear, you can see, here it is root and then shoot. It is, upper part is shoot and root. As the baby plant grows, it starts developing small green leaves inside the seed. The growing hook-shaped shoot straightens out and pushes the cotyledons above the ground. Gradually, the shoot elongates to form a proper stem, and its leaves unfold, eventually falling off the cotyledons. Finally, a mature plant does not show the cotyledons because they shrink and disappear with the growth of the baby plant. Clear to you? Here is the activity which can, through which we can, you can learn that how the seeds germinate. Soak some mung seeds or green gram in water. Then drain the water and tie this mung in a clean piece of cloth, and sprinkle some water on the cloth to keep it wet. Observe it after a day. You will see small white root-like structures coming out from the seeds. You can make this with the seeds of with the gram or the peas. Same activity you can do with that, and through that you can learn how the seeds germinate. Then take one seed in your hand and remove the green colored seed coat of the seed, and carefully observe the other parts of the seed. In this way you can grow new baby plants if you throw these seeds into soil, into a pot with a soil pot covered with the soil. Okay, so this was the activity, and in my next class I'll tell you again about the parts of plants and others, and I hope this chapter is clear to you. And till my next class, bye to all of you. Okay, and you all stay safe, and bye to all of you.